Happy Sabbath, happy day. My name is Sir Asli Machogu from Pathfinder Group, and I'd like to start this session with a word of prayer. Our kind everlasting Master, thank you for guiding us since last week until now. As we're going to start this session, be with us and protect us. In just one prayer and believe.
Worship the King of the Kings, serve the living Savior, the Creator of the world. Then Moses and Aaron went to the King of Egypt. How long will you deny to serve me to God? Let those people go and worship the King of the Kings, serve the living Savior, the Creator of the world.
It's a special day. I love tomorrow, yesterday, but today is my special day. Sunday, God made it a special day. I love tomorrow and yesterday, but today is my favorite day. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, hooray! What build an ark? The people thought it was a joke. The animals went in two by two, The blood you are from the kangaroo. So when you see the rainbow, when you see the rainbow, when you see the rainbow, remember God is love.
Satan is a liar as a fox. If I could catch and put him in the box, I lock the box and throw away the keys for all the things he has done to us. So satisfied with Jesus.
Satisfied with Jesus. Satisfied with Jesus. Remember God is love.
Amen. Happy Sabbath, children. I'm so grateful you've seen this day again. It's another day yet. We are not together, but God is with us wherever we are. So today we'll be learning a lesson about the floating zoo. Oh God. It was a time that Noah had been told to build an ark. I was so happy about it. And do you like to visit the zoo? Like us children, we love going to the zoos. We go to see the giraffes, lion, cheetah. We love to go to the zoo. And we always love to view the animals, how they eat, how they sleep. It's a joy to just visit the zoo and have a peaceful time in the zoo. So, when you're at home, can you guess what the floating zoo was? Yes, the floating zoo was the ark that Noah built. And Noah built this ark, and he was told to go in with the family, to go in with the animals. And these were the instructions. Take with you 7 pairs, each male with its female, of every kind of clean animal. You know, so if it was the giraffe, they could enter 2 by 2, a male and a female. If it was the elephant, it was 2 by 2. The second one was 1 pair of unclean animals, male and female. And the book is Genesis chapter 7, verse 2. That is where we get where God gave such instructions. So, now also the stock of the ark with food for himself and his family. Remember now, Noah is including the animals as his family. He was to stock the ark with food enough for the animals and his family. And it happened just as God said it would. The animals came to Noah out of the forest, walking, lumbering, hopping, you know, slithering, clawing, 2 by 2. If it was the rat, they could walk to the ark. If it was the kangaroo, they could hop to the ark. And now Noah had a new job. Like, he was like a chief's zookeeper because he was the owner of that ark, because he's the one who built it to the family. And now the wife could not stand in, but now he stood in and he was called the chief zookeeper. He was giving instructions. For example, Bradley, I've said you go and take care of the cows. I've said you go take care of the cats, go take care of the giraffe, giving them food, cleaning the place to make it that the place is clean, haying the grass for the animals to eat. It was so beautiful for them. Imagine how much work it was. But remember, it was God's work. And the people of Noah, the family of Noah, were supposed to do it without complaining, wholeheartedly, with a smile on their face. When your mom tells you, wipe for me the table, and you're like, mom, I don't feel like doing it. No, you're supposed to work according to the God's work has required you to work. Philippians 1 verse 27. And the message, it says, people in God's family work together. So us in church, we all are God's family. We all are family. And this family needs to work together in everything. If there is cleaning the chairs, don't complain. We youths, we love complaining. Oh, we know we have somewhere to go. Clean the chairs if you have to clean the chairs, because it's God's work. And it's telling us that work together as a team for faith. In prayer, in faith, in everything, in reading the Bible, in doing any chores at home. We thank God for you children. As you're at home, remember, take care of your parents, your grandparents. May God bless you. And I love you so, so much. I'm praying that God to remove this pandemic for us to meet once again. Your teacher has missed you. Stay at home. Be careful. Whatever you touch, whatever you drink, whatever you smell, wear your mask carefully. And may God bless you all. May we pray. Our Almighty Father, who art in heaven, we thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for the love that you've shown unto us. We as kids, O Lord, we are coming before you, O Father. May you forgive us our sins, and may you help us listen to our parents and help our parents work according to thy will. Be with us now until we meet again. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I do pray, trust and believe. Amen.
Passion will swallow you up. Sister, don't you understand? This world will make your failure in all you do. Passion will swallow you up. Sister, don't you understand? This world will make your failure in all you do. For the world is perishing with all its lies. This world is passing away. Where will you be? For the world is perishing with all its lies. This world is passing away. Where will you be? Goodbye, brother. See me again. If not in this world, in the world above. Goodbye, sisters. We'll meet again. If not in this world, in the world above. Goodbye, parents. We'll meet again. If not in this world, in the world above. For the world is perishing with all its lies. This world is passing away. Where will you be? For the world is perishing with all its lies. This world is passing away. Where will you be?
We thank our teacher for that beautiful lesson, and we hope every child in every part of our country has listened to it. Now we are going to welcome Bradley for our children's sermon.
Happy Sabbath. Happy day. My name is Bradley, and I'm the one who's going to tell you the children's story, entitled Jealousy and Envy Can Spoil Everything. The victory over Goliath made David famous. When King Saul, David, and their men were coming back from the war, the news had already reached to everyone in the country. Everyone started dancing, cheering, and singing. Saul has conquered thousands, and David tens of thousands. This song did not please King Saul at all. The next day, David was playing the harp for King Saul. But the music could not improve Saul's mood because David himself was the problem. When King Saul saw David sitting in front of him, he took his spear and threw it at him. But David was able to dodge it, and it stuck into the wall. From that day on, David did not feel safe around Saul at all. Saul hated David that he did not want to give him his daughter's hand in marriage. So he gave his eldest daughter to another man. Then he had another daughter by the name of Michelle, who had fallen in love with David. He had an evil plan to kill David. He told to David, go to battle with 100 Philistines, and if you come back, I will give you Michelle's hand in marriage. King David went with his men to the war, and they came back after killing more than 100 Philistines. So King Saul had to keep his promise, and he gave him Michelle's hand in marriage. Instead of rejoicing about the wedding, he continued to hate David. He thought to himself that God had left him and was now with David. And from that day, he was afraid of him. So in this story, we learn that jealousy and envy can spoil everything. And if we feel jealous or envious of a classmate or a friend, we need to ask God to help us understand it and overcome it. Thank you.
Happy Sabbath. Happy day. Hello, kids. Hello, parents back at home.
Thank you for watching. Till next time. Bye.